Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take a look at Safari's Responsive Design Mode. Now, if you have a website, then you want to make sure that it looks good for everybody that's viewing it, whether they're on a phone, an iPad, or a computer. And you've got all sorts of different screen sizes to consider. It can be very hard to test to see what it looks like. But with Safari in El Capitan, it's fairly simple because you can go to Safari Preferences and turn on the Develop menu. You do that under Advanced, Develop menu in menu bar there, and now you get this Develop menu and you can go into Responsive Design Mode and look what you get. You get this cool display that's going to show you the page you're looking at. You can go to another address just like you could if you were in normal mode, but it's going to show it to you in a little window inside of a window that's mimicking the size for one of these devices. So now, for instance, if you want to see what it looks like on an iPhone 4S, you click on the iPhone 4S and it shows it to you. And you can go through all these different devices here, like here's the iPad mini, the iPad Air 2, and most of these represent screen sizes for a larger set. For instance, the iPad Air 2, of course, the screen is the same resolution as the iPad Air 1 and the 4th gen iPad, for instance. So you can see what it looks like here. If you were to click another time, like let's go to the iPhone 6S, and click on it again, you can see it turns into horizontal mode. So you can go between these. The iPad Air 2 will actually switch between different screen modes, like showing you the split views and turning the iPad in different directions. So you can go through all of those. And in addition to that, you can also set the resolution here. So the iPad Air 2 at 1x, 3x, etc. And you've got general screen sizes like this. Just what does it look like on an 800 by 600 window or some other sizes. So here's a big desktop size. Here's a more typical laptop size, for instance. Here's maybe an older computer size. And you can stretch in any direction to change it here. So you can see. And you also have the ability to change it here at the bottom. So you can go beyond these settings to really see how responsive your design is. Now it's important to note that a lot of websites today are developed with responsive design, which means they change depending upon the screen size. So if you go to a smaller and smaller size, you can see our MacMost does this where suddenly it changes layouts completely once you go below 768 horizontally. So a couple notes about these items here. These don't actually show your web page is what it would look like in these browsers. Instead, it's just reporting to the server. It's faking out the server, telling it, hey, you're being shown in this browser in case the server is going to maybe adjust for things. So these are kind of expert mode and they're not what you think they are. And if you do use them, note that sometimes you get this little alert here saying you need to reload the page to tell the server that you've changed this user agent setting. But for most people, just checking on your own websites, just going through all these different versions here and seeing what you get and identifying any problems and either working on them on your own or having your web developer work on them and be aware of them is very important. So this is a useful tool for anybody that has a web presence.